Hello everyone, Ardawen here, and you would be surprised to, not see my face. But, you know what? Sometimes I want to do something else than watching the animes. And, today was such a day. Well, I could go outside, but there's people outside. I'm not going outside. So I decided to do the very next best thing. I decided to write a story. Now you might be thinking, but Ardawen, you have zero talent. Why, in the name of fuck, would you write a story? Well, first off, fuck you. And second off, you're absolutely right. But I didn't do it alone. I use the website talk2transformer.com. On this website, you can enter a line of text and an automatic algorithm does the rest. And I just did this over and over and over until some kind of story came out. Now, this one, it's a thing. It's a thing. And I decided to read it for you. Yes. Yes. I will read you a story. I don't even know the title because it's so weird, guys. It's so weird. In fact, I really need a beer while reading this because it's something. I don't know what it is, but it's something. I mean, my gender changes a bunch of times and I transport to different franchises a couple of times. Like, I don't even know what in the name of fuck. But I decided to keep it this way and just roll with it. So here we go. Are you guys ready? I mean, I'm not. But I gotta do it anyways. So if you have a suggestion for a title, please leave it in the comments. You guys are probably a lot more talented than I am. Alright. Here we go. So I started with the text. Ardawen was watching One Piece, as I often do. Ardawen was watching One Piece at the time and was impressed by how the series has developed so much over the years. In order to pay her respects, Ardawen gave a gift that he received from Luffy, which was a poneglyph. As Ardawen's poneglyph was still on the island, and it was later found by Usopp, who had gone to investigate the situation, Ardawen's memory of Usopp's gift was only partially accurate. It was actually a large stone with a number of names written on it. One of the names was Kuma. Ardawen was a very smart and skilled fighter, even surpassing Usopp's own strength, because he's so fucking strong, right? He also used the Ryoyuku Goblin in order to fight. When he met Shanks, Ardawen seemed to have a slight respect for him. This was shown when he was talking to a girl in a store with her. After hearing that Shanks was a captain, he started to ask the girl about him. But he started to run away and got attacked by an unknown assailant. However, when she came back to her senses and was saved by Ardawen and his other friends, the girl was taken aback by Shanks' words. She thanked him and also thanked him for saving her from the attacker. Shanks was impressed by Ardawen's ability to talk to girls in a way he can't, because I'm such a fucking smooth talker. He also seems to trust Ardawen's loyalty and faithfulness to him. Kanima, who was a student in the same class as Ardawen, because suddenly I'm going to school, I guess, also showed a great deal of respect for her. In the anime, Kanima first saw Ardawen at school when she was playing on her school's volleyball team and was practicing her swing shot with her sister. During a mission in which the girls are to rescue a hostage in the castle, Ardawen is seen training with a weapon on the beach and is shown to be a very skilled player. Yeah, sure. Ardawen is also shown to be very smart and clever in battle, often using a tactic that can be unthinkable to a normal person to defeat an opponent. During one battle, she was able to destroy a large part of a mountain using only her bare hands. She is shown to have strong emotional ties to her mother, which is shown when she was unable to go to the temple due to her mother being kidnapped by the soldiers of the empire. Certainly there is an empire, I guess. Ardawen was able to overcome her grief and go with her to the temple. Abilities. Ardawen is an extremely skilled warrior, able to take an entire army of the empire in her first battle. In another battle, she was able to completely destroy a mountain. She is shown to have incredible reflexes in battle, able to effortlessly dodge multiple shots from multiple people and even deflect bullets with her shield. I guess female me is pretty kick-ass. Her first battle against Kintoki ends with her winning the fight with his sword. I guess. In the manga, she wins the battle by using the power of the sun and uses a sword she obtained from a previous mission to beat Kintoki. The episode also depicts Ardawen fighting against a large snake while Kintoki and her are separated from her. This is a weird sentence. After she is reunited with her friends, they decide to go back and finish off the snake so they can return to the castle. When they arrive, they see that the snake was destroyed, but there is no sign of Kintoki and the others. Ardawen says that he is fine and he needs her help to find Kintoki and the others, and Kintoki agrees to help him out. Wait, what? To fight him herself? What? The next day, they all meet in the forest. There, they see Kintoki again, who shouldn't be left, I guess, but it seems he is hiding from them in some bushes. Hey, dude, are you hiding in some bushes from us? We see you. Kintoki tells Ardawen to go ahead and go after him and that he will be okay. Kintoki and his friends decide to go after Kintoki, while the others continue to search for them. Later on, when they are walking through the forest, Ardawen says that they must go find the castle as soon as possible. They go into the castle, which they apparently found very quickly, and Ardawen uses a spell that makes them both invisible, and they are able to pass through the door in a single breath. They then have the option to follow them into the room and the choice of where they go or not. See, this is what I meant. If they follow them, they see the king's chamber. It is full of all kinds of items and is even filled with dead bodies. Dun dun dun! Astrid, who's somehow suddenly there when we never met, but okay, has looked through them, and they notice that they are all children. Ardawen says that he must go through the castle and kill the children to take the item. But the children were already dead, and now I have to kill some children. Am I Anakin Skywalker or something? Jesus. They decide to go through, and it begins to get dark, but they are able to find their way through. Yay! They run into a room full of other Hogwarts students, because suddenly I'm apparently a Hogwarts student. Some are dead, some are still conscious, and some still have a knife sticking out of them. And some are in pieces. There is one man who has his eyes open. He turns around and he sees what's in front of him. And it's the knife. It was used to stab his friends. So he gets up. Then the knife comes down again and he runs and he gets his hands on the gun. He pulls the trigger suddenly. There was a gun apparently. And it's like the gun goes off again, but this time it's a warning shot. Okay. Then the sound of screams comes. He looks up and sees there's a giant dog sitting there. Then the giant dog goes towards him and then it jumps. And there's where I left the story. If you want this story to continue for some weird reason, then please tell me so in the comments. I guess you might now understand why I was a bit weirded out by the story, but I wanted to read it for you anyway. I don't think you had a lot of fun. I very much doubt that you listened all the way through. But if you did, well, good for you. I guess you have nothing to do with your life. So yeah, thank you for listening. Please leave a like. Please leave a comment. Please subscribe. And you know what? If you guys tell me that you want more, maybe I'll do more. Yeah, I see you guys in one of my other videos, I guess. Bye.